إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series concerning tafsir. We're still working on Surah Yasin, Surah number 36. Today, inshallah, we're going to be working in verse number 41. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين. We continue on with verses indicates the ability and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we've been discussing for the last 2 weeks. Starting from verse number 33, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep telling us, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ. He talk about the earth and he talk about the night and the sun and the moon. And today was saying in verse number 41, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ again. And we said the ayah, there is two ayah. There is a ayah, which is a verse of the Quran. And there is a ayah, which means a miracle. And there is a ayah, which means a sign, indication. As we understand that we could not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life. It's not because that Allah could not be seen. It's because that we don't have the ability to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And out of the mercy of Allah that He made hijab, He made a veil between Himself and us. And this hijab, this veil, is out of light. If Allah removed this veil, everything on the surface of this earth will be perished, will be destroyed. Out of the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the greatness of Allah. And the example that when the Prophet Musa alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, arini anzur ilayk, let me see, look at you, let me have the chance to look at you, after he heard the voice of Almighty Allah directly, with no Jibreel, with no any mediator, no agent. He heard Allah directly, as Allah said, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, and Allah spoke with Moses directly. Okay? So now, Musa, he want to get more out of this blessing and this happiness and joyful moment. Instead of only hearing, he want now to see the one that he's talking to him. So Allah told him, لَن تَرَانِي, you could not see me. Not Allah said, you could not, I could not be seen, but he said that you don't have the ability to see me. And this is Musa, not us. Okay? And we know about Musa, the strength and the power of Musa alayhi salam as a human being, that the well of water, which is the people used to get together and move the rock to water from it, he was able to do himself, by himself, and he watered the sheep for these two girls, alright? So, and out of his strength, that he pushed the man, فَوَكَذَهُ فَقَضَى عَلَيْهِ, he only pushed him, and the man fell dead. He was so strong, okay? So Musa thought that now, after this 40 days, being in the devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being in communication with Allah, now he is ready to see Allah. But Allah said, you could not see me. But look to the mountain, to the mountain. فَإِنِ اسْتَقَرَّ مَكَانَهُ فَسَوْفَ تَرَانِي, if the mountain remain in its place, you will be able to see me. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ جَعَلَهُ دَكَّا, when Allah reflected on the mountain, so the whole mountain gone, turned to dust. Now compare yourself as a flesh, blood, bones, skin, and mountains that drops, and all the solidarity and all the things, okay? That the mountain crumbled, became nothing but a dust, as if it not exist, was no rocks anymore, okay? And Musa, he was looking to the mountain, okay? Because Allah directed him and said, وَلَكِنْ انظُرْ إِلَى الْجَبَلِ, but look to the mountain. If the mountain capable to remain in its place, you will be able to see me. So Allah telling Musa and directly you, and not prepare physically to see me, but let see something more stronger than you, and this is the mountain. And if the mountain remains from in its place, now you'll be able to see, you have the capability that you can see me. So when Allah reflects, only matter of reflection, okay, the mountain is gone. And what happened to Musa? He fainted. When he got up, he said, glory be to you, glorify Allah. He got to know that he is not ready for this. So the what I'm trying to make here, that we as a human being, we are not capable to see Allah in this dunya. Okay? We are not prepared for it. We are not been made. Okay? Allah did not give us this ability here in this life. It will be there inshallah in Jannah. Okay? So since we could not see Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made ayat for us, made miracles for us, okay, made a signs for us, made a means and ways to indicate and to show as a evidence that He is there and He is the one. No anyone else beside Him. And since Allah Almighty sent messengers, and this out of His mercy, but the messengers are still human beings. And the human being after a certain time die. As example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not here anymore. Okay? So since we could not see Allah, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not here, so what is left for us to be guided? I'm not talking about the Muslim, we're talking about a human being in general. Okay? So Allah made ayat. Allah made ayat in verses for us to reflect and think about it, and made ayat in the creation in the universe that we can also see it and get to know that He is the Maker, that He is the true God, that He is our Master, and He's the one deserve for our worship and for us to debase ourselves to Him and to Him alone. So Allah told us about al-ard al-mayyita, the dead land, and how Allah revived it. Allah told us about the creation of things out of two pairs, male and female, in everything for production, for continuation of the time and the kind, trees, fruits, human beings, animals, birds, fishes, anything. He said, Subhana alladhi khalaqa al-azwaja kullaha. Everything made it in pairs. Okay? Even today, about germs and things that we could not know about it before, neither we can see it with our naked eye today, still, you can, that there is a pairs. Even in the atom, okay? Things which the Sahaba did not see or hear about it, Allah made it also. The electricity, everything for production. You found the cells, everything. Allah made everything. So Allah said, glory be to Him, the one who made all things, okay, in pairs, male and female. Male and female. مِمَّا تُنْبِتُ الْأَرْضِ وَمِنْ أَنْفُسِمْ وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Pairs out of what? He said, from what is the land producing? That means grains, vegetables, fruits, anything production of the earth. Allah said it's going to be pairs. Okay? Male and female. Alright? And وَمِنْ أَنْفُسِمْ and among us as a human being. We are pairs. Male and female. And Allah said what? Okay, since you see these things and you touch it, and وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So now, if you believe what you see, now I'm telling you about other things you could not see it. Or, if you see it by magnified glass, there is something that you don't know about. وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So He made things pairs in what? The production of the earth from a human being. And he said, وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And under the word, مِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, from what they don't know, you can list a long, long, big list. Okay? This is verse number 36. مِمَّا تُنْبِتُ الْأَرْضِ وَمِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Then Allah said, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ. Again, another ayah. Alright? Another sign. Another indication to lead you to Allah is what? الشمس تجري لمستقر الله. And as we stated last week, where is the sun runs and go to where? Until it go prostrate under the throne of Almighty Allah every day. And seek permission every day to come back. And Allah permitted it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us it will come a day that the sun will ask permission to come, that Allah will not permit it and say, go back from where you sat down. And this will be the major signs of the day of judgment, that the sun will come not from the east, will come from the west. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about al-qamar and the stations, okay, that he takes every day until the month is end. And he said that will be like al-urjun al-qadim, like the dry, curved, dead star. Okay? Exactly. We see this and we see it. So now, my point here is, since Allah we could not see him, and since the Prophet is dead, okay? So there is only one claiming all these things. There is one who's claiming that he's the doer of this, he's the creator of this. And he said, I did it, and I made it for you so you, it can lead you to me, so you can believe. So you have no excuse. The only one claiming this, and he wrote it in a book, is Allah. There is no one else, not Muhammad, not Jesus, not Moses, not the president, not the government. No one claim it. Allah is the one who claiming this. Our problem as a human being will try to attribute these things to others than Allah, although none of these things claim it. Okay? Like I stated in the Share Islam Day, this watch is mine. I know this is mine, and I say this is my watch. I say this is my watch. Everybody from those people who are sitting, nobody claim it. Why? Because it's mine. So Allah is the only one claiming that he's doing this. Nobody, somebody else coming and lying to us and telling us the mother nature. But where is the mother nature to tell us that I made the sun goes and make the moon sets and make the night comes and the day go away? Nobody claim it. But now they attribute it to Jesus. They want to attribute it to the mother nature. They want to attribute it to different things. Science. But there is nobody out of those claiming this. Allah is said, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ أَنَّا, that a miracle is a sign, is a mark for them, that we created for them, that we did. So the one who claimed and recorded and left it to be there is Allah. So, and nobody else had claimed it. But some of the human beings falsely tried to attribute this and say, oh, the mother nature doing it. But can the mother nature speak? Where do you have the deed that the mother nature claims this? We have a deed here claiming, Allah claiming this is my work. And I did this, and I'm doing it for you to be an ayah and to be a sign for you to believe. Subhanallah. Okay? So now why wouldn't you believe in the one who made the claim and he recorded this in the Lawh al-Mahfuz and sent it down, so like a deed certified, and somebody said, but this house is not blessed. But nobody claim it. You see? It's so amazing. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying again, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ الْفُلْكُ الْمَشْحُونَ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ أَنَّا حَمَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ فِي الْفُلْكِ الْمَشْحُونَ. You see? وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ again. So Allah was able to do what? To send us one ayah. Said, look to the land, how I give the dead land life, and the house after was dirt, that I make it produce. And when I make it produce, it gives the green and red and orange and apples and different colors, different taste. He can give us one plant, one example, one ayah. Why Allah repeating so? There is no excuse for you as a human being to go astray. Because that in everything there is ayah, that He is the one and the only one. And Allah told us in Quran also what? وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. And in your own self, why you don't reflect, why you don't think? You don't have to look too far. You don't have to be studying what you call science and chemistry and all these things. You don't have to be one of those physicians or people of science or people of chemistry or people or anything. Allah said to you, why don't you reflect in your own self? Okay? So here Allah is saying, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ أَنَّا حَمَلْنَا ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ فِي الْفُلْكِ الْمَشْحُونِ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ وَآيَةٌ لَهُمْ is a sign for them. And a sign لهم for them. The lamb is for, and the hum, the pronoun them, for them. Allah didn't have to make any ayah. He knows that He's the creator, He's the maker. But He made the ayah for what? For us. Is this ayah exist? Still until today? Everything is there? Yes. So why you don't believe? Why you don't submit? Why you don't listen? حَمَلْنَا we bore, carry ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ ذُرِّيَّة their offspring. And also it can apply to your ancestors, those before you. Okay? فِي الْفُلْكِ الْفُلْكِ the ship. المشحون شحن loaded. Okay. آية لهم أن حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون. Okay, maybe we did not see this one, which is the ark of Noah. But it's not an excuse for you. Don't worry about it. But at least this was a favor. This was a favor. Because if Allah did not protect our ancestors, our grandfathers, with Noah alayhi salam, those believers, because this is the only people who had remained on the earth. With the evidence and the dalil that when his son, he told him, "Rkab ma'ana, come and ride with us." He said, "Sa'awi ila jabalin ya'asimuni min al-ma." He said, "I will go to a mountain which will shield and protect me from the water." قَالَ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. He said there is no protection against the order and the command of Allah in today. Today? No mountain, not a palm tree, you climb all the way, it doesn't matter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us when the flood came, okay? فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عُيُونًا فَالْتَقَى الْمَاءُ عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ قَدْ قُدِرٍ. We opened the gates of the sky, rain coming, and we caused the earth to gush the water, so became water from the top and water from the bottom. And Allah said what? فَالْتَقَى الْمَاءُ لِقَاء, a meeting. That mean became up and down. So doesn't matter if you up or you down, wherever, now became everything flooded, everything was drowned, okay? Even the oceans themselves, okay? Allah made everything pouring from the bottom and raining from the top. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the water had met each other. So any human being in existence in this time that is not in the ark, he drowned and he died. So Allah is telling us about the favor that if he did not save those people, that they will in the fulk, the ship al-mashhoon. Mashhoon because was loaded. Okay? Was loaded. Plants take two bears. Animals, two bears. Fish take two bears. Human beings take all the those who believe with you. Okay? So all the believers in addition, two of everything, because the destruction will reach everything. Human being, animals, everything. So Allah saying, and the ayah, how a ship remain, the water is flooding up and down, and the only thing was
survived
is this ark of Noah. Okay? So this is a favor. But since you did not see this, you only heard about it. So look, the verse comes after this is saying what? وَخَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ مَا يَرْكَبُونَ وَخَلَقْنَا We created لَهُمْ for them men from مِثْلِهِ similar. Okay, so there's no excuse for you now. You didn't see the ark of Noah. But we made other things which is not exactly but similar, okay, which you use it for what? For to ride.
Vessel.
You have a car, you have a bus, you have an aeroplane, you have boats, you have ships, you have name it, okay? So if you did not see the favor of Allah upon mankind by saving the believers and your ancestors, okay, all right, you didn't see this, but don't worry about it, because what? We had created for you something similar to what had saved those people. We made similar to you, which you utilize it to ride it. So Allah is telling us, I'm giving you your rides. Okay? The car, Allah didn't create the car. Who sends the iron? Allah, there is a whole surah in the Quran called Surah Al-Hadid. The iron. Okay? So if you don't have the iron, how are you going to? Okay? Everything, Allah. Okay? So Allah is still, again, from His rahmah and ni'mah blessings, giving you a favor and a blessing and making it what? An ayah for you. To know, a sign for you. So you can believe. Anybody else who will claim this? Somebody said they understand made by Ford. Somebody said made by Chevrolet. But made what? They fabricated, put it together, but the originality came from where? Yeah. Did you make it? Did you create it? Of course not, okay? وَخَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ مَا يَرْكَبُونَ What the, from the verb رَكَبَ رَكِبَ, okay? But listen here. Continuing with the favor and the sign. A favor and a sign, okay? Because he said, وَإِنَّ شَأْ نُغْرِقُهُمْ فَلَا صَرِيخَ لَهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْقَذُونَ وَإِنَّ شَأْ نُغْرِقُهُمْ فَلَا صَرِيخَ لَهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْقَذُونَ وَإِنْ نَشَأْ If it goes back to the will of Allah وَإِنْ نَشَأْ If we will شَاءَ يَشَاءُ Like you say مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ Okay? The will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala نُغْرِقُهُمْ If Allah Yes You have a ship You have cruise What you call the cruise cruiser
Cruise ship.
A cruise ship and people dancing and drinking and don't ask me how I know about that. Swimming pools there, people,
everything.
All kind of things, okay? But subhanAllah, look what Allah said. وَإِنَّ شَأْ نُغْرِقْهُمْ Yes, you're having fun, You jumping, you playing, you guys doing all kind of things, getting drunk, you understand? Women naked and men drinking and all kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Allah is saying, I made it an ayah, but by the way, you are using it. But Allah is saying, وَإِنَّ شَأْ نُغْرِقُهُمْ. Okay? Make غَرِيق, drown. Make it drown, نُغْرِقُهُمْ. Allah is capable. Doesn't matter how big is the motor. Okay, they have it now 7 floors and 10 floors and big towers and all kind of things. But if Allah wants, He will do it.
Titanic.
Subhanallah.
Can't be sink. The Titanic. No. Allah put it under the water.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bigger ship than this. And what you call an army ship or what you call it? Many things, you understand? Recently they discovered some, they found it under the ocean. Mm-hmm. After how many hundreds of years? Mm-hmm. Okay, disappear and after the, subhanallah. And you're talking about not a cruise, you understand, for fun. This is metal and is an army, like an army tank. And how Allah made it drown. Mm-hmm. The officers, the captains, everybody. And Allah still can do it again. Mm-hmm. And it's saying, and if we will, so it's back to Allah's will. It's not about how much, you understand, your intelligence and the captain, the command, in nasha, if we will nughrikum, we make them drown. فَلَا صَرِيخَ لَهُمْ. And if Allah calls them to die, even if they can shout, help, help, okay? فَلَا صَرِيخَ لَهُمْ. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْقَذُونَ. And they could not be saved. And an ayah sign for them is that we bore their offspring in the laden ship of Noah. And we have created for them of the like there into, on which they ride. And if we will, we shall drown them, and there will be no shout or helper for them, or to hear their cry for help, nor will they be saved. Subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَمَتَاعًا إِلَى حِينٍ. إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَمَتَاعًا إِلَى حِينٍ. إِلَّا except. Why? Not drowning. Mm-hmm. And the possibility that it can is the will of Allah, number one. And number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, unless it is, it be rahmah,
mercy.
A mercy. Minna, from us, that means from Allah. Wa mata'an, and as enjoyment. إِلَى حِين. حِين means a while. Okay? So what does it mean? He's saying about the kuffar, Allah giving them, showing them rahmah. Of course. Mm-hmm. What you see that the kuffar is still eating and drinking. Some of the kuffars may be riding a better car than you, have a better house than you.
Yes.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving them the chance. Yes, you're drinking. Yes, you're doing the haram. You in the middle of the water. Okay, and Allah can make it like this and drown. Mm-hmm. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَعَلَيْهِ. This is only a mercy. وَمَتَاعًا, give you enjoyment. إِلَى حِين. Okay, because we're going to let you go back again home. You see your children. You be back again, you understand, to the shore. All the things. That maybe you will hear a word of wisdom. And you may understand, reflect. You may see the ocean. You will see the waves, how strong. And he was about to die and he didn't die. Maybe this will bring a reminder to you and make you return and get to see the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to them, as he told us, that لو كانت الدنيا تعدل عند الله جناح بعوضة ما سقى كافرا منها شربة ماء. If the whole dunya means to Allah anything, not even equal, if it means to Allah equal a wing of a mosquito, if the value of the whole dunya equal a wing of a mosquito, he's not going to give the kafir a drink of water. But means nothing to Allah. So Allah is still giving them respite, giving them time, giving them a safe journey, all the things that they may reflect. But he gave them the ship and the cruiser and all the things so you can reflect and think and see how with all this load and all these 7 floors, okay, 10 floors, and all the thousands of people in, and they floating in the water. Subhanallah. Okay? It's a miracle. People don't think about these things. Okay? Mm-hmm. It's very big load, but it's floating. Okay? Subhanallah. Okay? And Allah is giving them a time, a chance. So He sent a messenger. He sent a book, and it's still the book talking about the ayat and the miracles, and for them to reflect. There is a sign that in the book that you read, and there is ayat that you go over it, and there is ayat that you see and you hear, okay? Which one will bring you back to Allah or make you understand that there is a creator that you need to submit to Him? It's good and it's fine. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahman Rahim. He doesn't want you to go to hellfire. So He gave you more than one ayah. It's what you eat, what you drink, your stomach, your eye, the function of life, the winds, the moon, the sun, what you see, what you touch, what you feel. Okay? All the things to be. So the numbers of ayat, so a human being could not have excuse before Allah. Is the day with your children. وَمَتَاعًا إِلَىٰ حِينٍ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَمَتَاعًا إِلَىٰ حِينٍ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اتَّقُوا مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَمَا خَلْفَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. And we have created for them of the like, okay, their into in which they ride, and if we will, we shall drown them, and there will be no shout or helper for them to hear their cry for help, nor will they be saved, unless it be a mercy from us, means Allah, and as an enjoyment for a while. And when it is said to them, beware of that which is before you, and that which is behind you. So Allah reminded them, now we talk about boats and water and fruits and vegetables and moon and sun. So maybe the things understand is not working. And we said that Islam work on targhib and tarheeb. Encouragement, it makes some people work. And there is something too, like a Bashir and Nazir. Some people go with the glad tiding. And some people, glad tiding doesn't work too much with them. So now comes the warning. So if it's been said to them, all this ayat, you don't see it, you don't pay attention. اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم What is in front of you and what is behind you? All the disasters that happen. Why you don't
pay attention?
Pay attention. Today is an earthquake. Tomorrow is, you understand, somebody hijack an aeroplane. Yesterday, somebody, I don't know if you heard about what happened in Bangladesh.
Yeah.
Last night, I think it was yesterday.
Subhanallah.
Yes, subhanallah, okay.
What happened?
A whole factory, buildings or whatever, collapsed. Yeah. Okay? So things is happening every day. Illness, sickness, okay? Germ. So Allah made many things happening every day in your country or some places. And today is supposed to be more for us warning. Why? Because before something happened in Bangladesh or even North Carolina, you're not going to know about it. You're in South Carolina. But today, like this, with the internet, with the media, with all these things, you will know it immediately. Not know it, you get to even to see it. And this supposed to be scare us and supposed to be listening for us. So Allah said, "Taqu ma bayna aydikum," the things that happening. You see it today. We see it more now than the Muslims and non-Muslims before us. So Allah said, "Taqu ma bayna aydikum." If you could not even see what's happening overseas, see what's happening to you yourself. Today you failed the exam, or tomorrow you understand you are sick. Or the next day your wife lost the baby. Or yesterday you understand the fire from your job. All these things that happening is supposed to be a warning for you. Come back to Allah. Stop the haram. Do the, huh? اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم. So if what is happening in front of you and you experience day to day is not enough, think about what is coming. وما خلفكم. What is coming, which is more serious, which is hellfire. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made even the changing of time and corruption and illness and weakness in the nations and all these things to be a warning for the people to come back to Allah. So Allah telling us that He also is the one who's the cause behind all these things. So, and He made it to be a beneficial for some people if they open their eyes. Okay? It's a disaster, earthquake, but it will put some fear in your heart. It make you understand, start to give donation, start to do something, okay? For these people who are in a bad shape. All these things is a warning for us and to make us to believe or to make tawbah, or to be a better Muslim. Okay? وَمَا خَلْفَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. So learning from what's happening and what is going to happen in the grave, in the day of judgment, it will bring a mercy for us. It will bring a rahmah for us. How? Because we're going to repent. We're going to believe. We're going to start to increase our obedience to Allah and slow down in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah made these things to be a sign and a reminder for us. Continue next week if Allah will. Thank you for being here. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Allahumma is best.